Hello students, so in the previous session already we have started the lesson the microorganisms. So in that one regarding the microorganisms and the types of microorganisms already we have seen, that is the useful microorganisms and harmful microorganisms. So in that one the first type, that is the useful microorganisms, we have seen in the previous session in detail. So how the organisms are going to help the human beings in our life. So in our life how the microorganisms are going to behave in good manner, that we have seen in the previous session in detail. So let us see about the harmful microbes. Those are also called the pathogens. So the pathogens means the organisms that are going to cause or that are going to bring the diseases. So the disease causing microorganisms are called the pathogens. So here we can see that the pathogens are the different types of pathogens are there. So maybe it is the bacteria or the virus or the protozoans or the fungus. So variety of organisms or microorganisms are there that can bring the different types of the diseases to our body. So here the diseases may be going to transfer by the any of the mediums like the water that we drink or the food that we eat or by the air that we breathe. So the microorganisms are very active and they can transfer their diseases or they can bring the diseases by the any of the medium. So here some diseases are there which are going to transfer from one person to the other person by the air, water or by the other physical movements also. So here the examples now presently the very famous corona disease is there. So that is disease which is going to transfer from one person to the next person. So these kinds of diseases, so which are going to transfer from one person to the other person, so that kind of organisms or that kind of diseases are called the communicable diseases. So here some other diseases are also there, so which are going to cause their effect on the person by the carriers. So some diseases are there which are actually came by the carriers. So suppose the disease causing microorganisms are present in our surrounding, so those disease causing microorganisms will come to our body by some carriers, such as the mosquitoes or by the house flies and other insects also. So when they will sit on the disease carrying microorganisms, so they will attach to the carriers or to the house fly or the mosquito. So when they will come and they will sit on the food or water or by on the body of the person, if the person is going to eat that kind of food or water, so it will be transferred to the healthy person. So like this, some carriers are there, they will bring the diseases from the patient to the healthy person. So here variety of diseases are there, variety of the microorganisms are there, so they will bring the variety of different types of the diseases. So not only to the human beings, to the plants as well as to the different kinds of the animals also, they are going to suffer by the different types of diseases which are brought by the microorganisms. Now I will show you some of the examples, so which are given to your syllabus. So see. So students, here we can see the variety of different human diseases, the causative microorganisms and the mode of transmission and whatever the preventive measures we have to take, that is given in this list. So here the tuberculosis is the human disease that is caused by the bacteria and it is going to transfer by the air.
and so many kinds of the diseases are given in this list. So malaria is there, that is caused by the protozoa. So this protozoa will be carried by a mosquito. So here the hepatitis A is there, that is also caused by the virus, and that will come by the water. So typhoid, that is very familiar disease, that is the high fever disease. So that is caused by a bacteria that will come by the water. So Salmonella typhi is the example bacteria that can cause the disease called the typhoid. So cholera is there, that is also the bacterial disease that will come by the water or by food also. So here some list is given, that is the polio, that is caused by the virus that will transfer by the air or by water also. So these are the some diseases that are given in your textbook also, that you can see properly and that you have to remember. So these are the some diseases that are caused by the different kinds of microorganisms. So not only these, so plants are also going to suffer by the different kinds of diseases, such as the citrus canker, rust of wheat, and yellow vein mosaic bendy. So this is the list of the plant diseases that are caused by the microorganisms such as bacteria, fungi, and virus. So citrus canker is caused by the bacteria, rust of wheat is caused by the fungi, and yellow vein mosaic bendy is the disease that is caused to the plant by the virus. So here, so we can see the variety of the different diseases are there that are caused by the microorganisms. So here not only these, we can see the different kinds of some kinds of diseases are there, like some diseases like the anthrax. So the anthrax disease is caused by a bacteria called Bacillus anthracis. So this was actually discovered by Robert Koch in the year of 1876. So Robert Koch discovered the disease called anthrax. So anthrax is a disease that is going to cause to the human beings as well as the cattles. So cattles and human beings also suffer with the same kind of disease called the anthrax. So the remaining portion, that is about the microorganisms and their effects, we will see in the next session. Thank you.